So we are discussing about exceptional handling in Java, and in the last module we have discussed try catch mechanism. In addition to this try catch mechanism, there are many more features so far the exception handling is concerned. So today we will discuss few of them, and then other features, advanced features also there. So, those things will be discussed in our next module. Now we have discussed about try and catch block, and there is another, this is a simple what is called the exception handling mechanism. Now, apart from this simple, there is also one more mechanism, it is called try with multiple catch. So, there are many features, so try with multiple catch is the one. So, here the idea is basically the methods where we are interested to maintain the exception handling. So, suppose this is the entire method, and then so try with multiple catch implies that there is only one try block and there is many catch block. So, two or more catch blocks are there, then it is called the try with multiple catch. Here is the concept is that in the try block, it will catch whatever the exception it will occur. So, only one try. So, try block will responsible for to catch all the exceptions, and for each exceptions we have to maintain the catch block, so that the corresponding exception for a corresponding catch block will take care. So, this is the concept. So, try catch block is basically to indicate that if there are multiple errors or exceptions occurs in a program, they can be tried with one try block and they can be caught with multiple catch block. Now, here is an example, very simple example to explain how the try with multiple catch will work. Now, let us look at this program. Now, we can see there are multiple points where the errors may occur. As you can see in this program, so it is basically considering the command line arguments. So, if the command line arguments is there, so it basically has the arcs length, that means it how many inputs that user has passed through the command line that will be stored here. And after that, we can see this is the one point where there is a scope of error or exception. Why? This is because if user does not provide any input, in that case I equals to 0, and if I is 0, then this is not a valid one, what is called a declaration, it is called the null pointer exception. Now, another here is also, if you see there is also one scope of error. If user does not pass any input, then arcs 0 is also a null pointer. And there is another also, you can see here at this point also one error. So, if I equals to 0, so it is basically the arithmetic exception, namely the divide by 0 error. And here also, if you see there is a possibility of error if the value of I is more than 2, because here the I then array is initialized with 2 elements. So, array index is varying from 0 and 1. So, size of the array is 2, and then here if I is suppose 3 or more than 1, that means 2, then it basically gives an error, it is called the array index out of bound error. So, as you see this program can run for some input, but not necessarily it will run for all inputs. So, if the program does not take care about all those exceptional input, then it is the exception, and this way this program is in fact not so robust. So, there are few input, as you can see if you try this program with all these inputs, you can see these are the, so this is the one exception occurs in this input, here also exception occurs, and here also the exception may occurs. So, there is a different exception that may occur for the different input like this. Now, so as a way out of these things, so they are basically, as I have mentioned again, let us specific, as there is one vulnerabilities, here is also errors may occur and there is also error occur. So, there are 3 points where the error occurs. So, multiple errors, multiple exceptions. So, here is the idea about that how we can handle with try with multiple catch. So, idea is that we can include all the statement where exception may occur under the try block, and for each exception we can plan the catch block. So, here is an idea about these things which the program has been rewritten with try with multiple catch. Now, let us look this program little bit carefully, we will be able to see this is the program that where we have included try with multiple catch. As you can see here is that this is the basically methods portion where the exception may occurs at this point, this is the one point, this is the here and this is here, these are the 3 points where the exception may occurs. And to catch this exception we have mentioned one catch, this catch is basically to handle the null pointer exception error mainly here. And this catch is basically to handle arithmetic exception error divide by 0 error here, and this catch is basically to handle the array index out of bound error here. So, as we see for the different exception we can plan the different catch block. Now, this is obviously not possible with simple try catch block because it will catch only one exception, but there is a master exception we can consider, this is possible, but if we want to pinpoint or more specific about what particular errors or exception occurs, then definitely we should think for try with multiple catch. Now, so this is the one features we have learned about simple try and catch, then we have discussed about try with multiple catch, and also it is possible to catch by means of only single catch block, but the multiple errors are there. That is what I just wanted to discuss about these things in a different way that we have discussed in the last year, try with multiple catch, but more errors in the last example that we have seen, but we have planned more catch block, but here multiple errors, but single catch block. So, this is the one idea about. So, here is the one concept is like this. So, this is the method as where the exception may occurs, and then this is the try. Here in this part many errors may occur as in the last example that we have discussed, but there is one catch that can handle whatever the exception it is there. Now, here is an example that we can see, this is a very nice example to explain this concept very carefully. Now, here if we see, so this is the method, main method actually here. Now, under this main method as we see there are many point of exceptions that may leads. So, here is the one point of exception because 0 equals to here divide by 0 error. Now, here also you can see as b is initialized with a null pointer and we want to have access b 0, the 0th element, this is also an error. And here also you see here the array c is declared with size 2 only, but here we want to access the 10th element which is also not possible. And here also if you see this is a string and we want to find the character at 9th position where is the string has maximum up to 3rd location, index is 3. So, here the string index out of bound, here the array index out of bound, here the null pointer assignment and here the arithmetic exception. So, there are so many errors that may leads to whenever we want to run this program. So, this program if we run then it will give always this error because the static error that is there. Now, let us see what we can do so that this program will be more robust, more reliable. So, this can be implemented with only one catch and then one try. So, idea it is like this, here you can see. So, this is basically as we have mentioned the try block, so that whatever the error it will occur, it will try to see whether if any exception or error occurs or not, and then here we can see a single catch. Now, in this catch if we see, we have thrown an exception of the class exception. Now, in other example, in the last example, we have mentioned the exception of a particular class, say null pointer exception or arithmetic exception or divide by zero exception or like this. Okay. So, here is basically we will catch the all, this is basically the super exception class. So, it will catch any sort of exception whatever it is there, but if we write the catch with say array index out of bound exception e, then only that kind of exception that this catch block will handle. But here the single catch will catch any kind of exception that may occur. So, it is a general one implementation, and here also you can see for the different exception the different message is mint already in the exception class it is there. So, this basically will print e dot get message, that means it will tell that okay, it is array index out of bound exception or what type of exception it is there. So, this is the idea about multiple errors with single catch. So, sometimes whenever we are not sure about if any exception will occur in our program, then usually programmer will prefer this kind of things. So, only say one try and one catch, that catch will consider or handle only the object exception e. So, this is a very simple one approach of course, sometimes it is okay, but in some cases whenever we need say details error or exception mechanism, this is not so much preferable anyway. So, this is the things that we have learned about simple try catch, try with multiple catch, multiple errors with single catch. Now, in addition to this, there is another concept, it is called the finally associated with this try catch block. So, the idea about this finally is that, so try catch we have already learned about it, then it will contains another block is called the finally. So, it is basically the idea is that if there is any exception occurs or not occurs. So, in that case the finally will always execute for you. So, this means that it always execute this code. So, this code is basically helps to the programmer that if an error occurs, then what is the remedy for that error. So, programmer can have the flexibility to mention or in prompt to the user, so that if this is the error occurs, so what the user should do like this, and if it does not occur, you can say that okay, the program is running successfully, this kind of things. So, this is the idea about finally. Now, let us have a small example to explain the concept of finally here. Now, in this program if we see, we have declared an array, the name of the array is greetings, which will be initialized with three strings, hello twinkle, hello java, hello world, and so it is basically greetings has the index from 0 to 2, 0, 1 and 2. Now, here if we run this while loop, then okay, for I equals to 0, 1, 2 it will work, but for 3 and after that it will basically gives an error or exception. This is because so I greater than, if I is equals to 3 and it will try to find this one, right, for I equals to 3, then greetings, because it is 0, 1, 2 maximum. So, 3 in this case it will gives an error. So, this loop if we roll, it will roll for first 3 input 0, 1 and 2, but for 3 it will give an exception. Now, here the finally catch is basically for each iteration it will there is no exception. So, catch will not do anything, but finally will say that whenever I is greater than 3, it will basically gives that error. So, this is the idea about that the finally will finally a block can be added in addition to try catch block to give more flexibility to the user. Now, Java also allow programmer to throw exception explicitly. Now, all these examples that we have discussed, that it is basically implicit throw, that means whenever the exception will occur, the Java runtime management manager basically will check it and then try for any exception if it occurs and then catch it. But sometimes we can throw the exception of our own. So, this can be done by throw clause. So, there is a throw clause, it is there. Now, for example, here as we see, so this is a simple try catch block in a block, and here is a throw exception object. So, different type of exception and corresponding exception can be thrown by this one. So, this is the throw clause. Okay. So, by writing this throw, so far in our previous example we have not used this throw. Now, we are going to use this throw that explicitly it will throw an exception objects. Now, this is basically if you find some error during some input or in your program or system, then you can throw explicitly. That is why the Java developer has maintained this kind of concept here. Now, let us have an example here. So, a throw can also throws many exception, that is also possible. And so, there is again other than this throw, there is also one throws, that means if it throws multiple exception. So, this is the idea about, let us have an example, so that we can discuss, we can learn this example and then have the full idea about it. Now, this is one simple program that we can just check it. Now, here we have created one exception, the name of the exception is my exception, and this is basically then inherited a super class of exception actually. So, it is a derived class of super class exception. As you know that exception class is already defined in this Java dot lang package. So, this is the concept that we have to create an exception class. So, it is basically user created exception class, and so what message that this exception class can give to the user is basically this is the message, and this is the constructor that is defined in the exception. So, using this constructor is basically overloading, and this basically is a definition of the constructor of this my exception class actually. And so, this this part is basically declare a exception class of user's own. So, it is a user's own exception. Now, I will discuss about there are many built in exception classes are there. Now, this is the one user defined exception class anyway. Now, once you define the user exception class, then you can create an object of that class, and here is an example. Now, if we see this example, so this is a very simple one. So, this is the main method as we see, and here the possibility of causes of error it is there, obviously y is 0, but in this case you see y is always 1000 static value. So, no, but sometimes user can tell that if this ratio is within not threshold. For example, if z is less than 0.01, then only you can raise the exception. So, here actually if z which will come from this arithmetic operation is less than this one, then it will throw this is the exception with this message. So, this is the use of the explicit throwing an exception in a method, and then this is the catch. As you see, this will catch the exception of this type and then the message the block for the catch, and this is the finally, as we have mentioned that it will always execute whenever there is an exception occurs or if not occur. If there is an exception occur, you can maintain the code what it should do and whatever it is there. So, this is the idea about throw clause. Now, here is another example of throw clause, the same thing here we have declared one class, the name of the class is throw demo, and where there is one method called the demo proc, and in this method we declare our own try block. Here is try throw new interrupted exception, this is basically user defined exception and interrupt occurred. And whatever the code there in the demo proc, and then this exception if it occurs it will catch using this catch block, and this catch also can throw other expression is basically throw an expression to the caller program actually, because it is a procedure whenever it is called it will throw to the caller actually. So, now here this is the caller program here which will call this demo proc, and it calls it. Now, if any exception occurred because of the some code here, it will throw, and this exception E will catch this exception which is called by this one here also, and this will print like this. So, there are many usage of this throw exception. More basic concept here is that it can throw any exception which user wants to throw it in this program, so that the program is more robust. So, this is the throw concept there in block, and there is again throws also possible in exception handling to handle the exception in a Java program. Now, for this purpose the Java programmer proposed an idea about it. So, suppose we want to throw an exception whatever it occurs in a method, let this is the name of the method where we want to throw multiple exceptions, then you should use throws catch, and then whatever the exception that you have you anticipate you can made it there list. So, if there is a say array out of bound exception, so array out of bound exception comma, if there is a null pointer assignment then comma, and so. So, this basically list of all exception that this throws can throw, and so that the corresponding the catch block will be there, they can catch it. So, the idea here it is that this throws command will throw multiple exceptions that may occur in a method. Now, so idea it is, now let us have the one simple example, so that we can understand about this one. Yes, now this program we have once discussed in our demonstration as well as while we are discussing about the input output. As we see in this program there are many point where the exception may occurs. Now, let us examine one by one. So, here is basically if you see in this part there is no point of exception, but here if we see here data input stream in this one. Now, here if suppose it is not possible to this program is not able to create any object of data stream in, then an exception will leads, because this in is referred in subsequent here, here in many situation. So, if this object is not created, then in the subsequent points it will raise many exceptions are there, and this is because Java is basically an interpretative manner. So, if this fails, then obviously it will not stop here, it will try to give execute it, and then in every point it will point out the exception. Anyway, so there is a possibilities that here an exception may occur in the sense that in the data input stream object is not successfully created for some reason, and also system dot in it is basically standard input. Suppose your keyboard is not working properly while you are running this program, or one's input device is not working which basically map to system in, then in that case also this object will not be created. Now, so these are the basically system dot out dot plus, there is no point of is basically clean the buffer, the concept it is there. Now, here you see there is again in read line, if suppose this buffer is not able to read successfully for some reason, then here also there will be an exception, and here also another exception if the buffer is not able to read at this point, and here is also another exception if the buffer is not able to read at this point. Okay, so we see there are three different points where the exception occurs, and in this particular example only one particular type of exception that occur. Now, you can define that exception of your own. If you define, then you can mention that in this throw block, so that is the exception, but here without taking any what is called risk, we have discussed the throw exception. Any type of exception if it occurs in this particular code, then this throws will throw an expression explicitly, and then this catch will catch this exception E. So, the idea about that, any exception if it occurs here, this throws, as it is mentioned here, will throw the exception in the try block, and then corresponding exception will this one. Now, here if I do not write this one also and only this part, also it will work. This is particular case is that, because there is a obvious responsibility of Java runtime manager, Java runtime manager will automatically take care this part whenever exception occurs. But sometimes the exception which is basically as per the requirement of the program, say some specular, in this case it is not working of course, but in some situation, say suppose I am telling you one example, say in dot read line it is working correctly, but I want to see that if suppose I have to enter say two digit number, if user enter one digit, so in that case after reading this one I can throw an exception occurs according to my own requirement like this one. So, in that case this throws, or here also after seeing these things we can write throw. So, out of this there are many ways actually. So, we can write this one and then do all these things, we can have this one not required but this one, or we do not have this one here but throw here, throw here, throw here. So, explicitly there are many ways the exception can be handled actually. So, whatever be the way, basic idea is that all these things should be catch, either using multiple catch or simple catch, whatever it is there. So, this is the idea, the concept for the throw in try catch mechanism. So, we have discussed about many other features regarding the exception handling in Java, and there are many few more in this line. They are basically, we have discussed only few exception handling concept. Apart from this, there are many other different exception classes defined in java.lang package. So, those things definitely a programmer should know about it, then they can use it for program in a better wider domain actually if you want to develop it. And there is also another possibility. Java makes more what is called the flexible, in the sense that it allows user to define their own exception. Now, in our next module we will discuss about how a user can define their own exception, and then those exception can be handled, and whatever the built in exception classes are there in Java program. Thank you very much.